Number 10, Clive Anderson. It's important to note that while all late night hosts do work hard to remember what projects every single one of their guests is promoting, they can easily get mixed up from time to time. And that's exactly what brought forth one of the most awkward encounters in UK TV history. When the Bee Gees appeared on Clive Anderson's All Talk in 1997, they grew so tired of his continuous jokes about their music that they infamously just got up and walked off set. As a poor attempt at humor, the host made remarks about the group's appearance and said that he thought the band were sisters rather than brothers, and that only his dog loves their high-pitched music. But the big turning point came when Anderson said that the band will always be Le Tossers to me, and you could literally see Barry Gibb's face begin to darken. To make matters worse, when the singer tried to talk about a song that he had written earlier in his career, saying he had forgotten that one. Clearly not loving the atmosphere, Barry became sarcastic and said, "We're getting on like a storm, aren't we, Clive?" before getting up on his feet and cursing at the host. He got up and left, and after even more awkwardness, the other two eventually did the same. Number 9, Katie Couric. In 2014, the television personality invited trans model Carmen Carrera to appear on her talk show Katie. After Carmen discussed her modeling career, Couric began asking her really invasive questions about her transition, like, "Was the whole process painful physically for you? And your private parts are different now, aren't they?" As the questions were becoming increasingly personal and insensitive, Carmen finally decided to say something. Quote, "I don't want to talk about it because it's really personal. I'd rather talk about my modeling stuff. I'd rather talk about being in W and maybe being in Italian Vogue and doing fun stuff and showing people that after the transition, there's still life to live." It was actually a great opportunity for Carmen to demonstrate that she is more than her transition and that being trans is not the most interesting thing about her. For her part, Couric received some pretty intense backlash for her line of questioning, especially when Orange is the New Black star Laverne Cox appeared on the show and told the host that she was objectifying Carmen. It wasn't until 2017 that Couric revealed that she had the opportunity to cut the segment out of the interview altogether, but decided to keep it in as an educational moment for her audience. So she definitely learned something from the experience. Number 8, Jessica Simpson. Of all the celebrity talk show fails, this one is easily one of the messiest and the hardest to watch. When the singer appeared on the Ellen DeGeneres show in 2017, it quickly became clear that she had had one too many. Jessica slurred her words and fumbled over a range of topics, including the length of her marriage to Eric Johnson, which she said she couldn't remember, and then started talking about contraception, saying, "We got an IUD, nothing's going to get into that uterus." And when Ellen asked her about whether she was expanding her billion-dollar business, Jessica started rambling about vitamins and B12 energy. When asked if she's making more music, she claimed that she is, but she struggled to remember just how many songs she actually has. Quote, "I probably have about 38 or maybe 36 or 39. And Ellen said bluntly, "You don't have 38 songs." It really wasn't until 2020 that the singer addressed the incident in her tell-all memoir called Open Book, when she admitted to having drank before going on air. She claims that she's still so embarrassed by her behavior that she can't bring herself to watch the interview almost 3 years later because it was a weak moment for her and she said she wasn't in the right place. But in recent years, she seems to be doing a whole lot better.
At number 7, Joan Rivers. Apparently, late night TV host Johnny Carson and Joan Rivers had so much beef that he not only banned the comedian from his show, but he also refused to speak to her for the rest of his life. When Carson became the host of The Tonight Show in 1962, Joan was starting to rise to fame for her comedy. She and Carson became a pretty dynamic duo as she appeared in his late night show almost 100 times. She was hired as a writer and even became a guest host when Carson was away, but in the mid 80s, that's when things started to turn bad as Joan was upset that NBC never offered her a long-term contract. When talks of Carson's retirement began, there was a list of potential candidates of who would replace him, and to her astonishment, Joan wasn't on that list. The silver lining there was that Fox later contacted her about having her own late night show, and she jumped at the opportunity. This made Johnny really mad because he felt like he was almost being blindsided by the whole thing. This caused them to have a pretty big falling out, which led to Joan being banned from her former friend's show. But speaking out about the drama between them, Joan went on to say, quote, "I think he really felt, because I was a woman, that I was his, that I wouldn't leave him. I know this sounds very warped, but I don't understand otherwise what was going on. For years, I thought that maybe he liked me better than the others. but I think that it was a question of, I found you and you're my property. He didn't like that as a woman, I went up against him. End quote.
Number 6, Dua Lipa. At first, the interview seemed to be going really well until some awkward questions were asked by Dua Lipa that made everyone watching pretty uncomfortable. During an episode of The Tonight Show with Jimmy Fallon, Dua was guest hosting and she accidentally referred to Gwen Stefani's partner at the time, Blake Shelton, as her husband when they were not married. She started off the friendly conversation by saying, "So I heard that you've been spending quarantine with your husband, Blake Shelton, at the ranch in Oklahoma. Who else was with you? How was that?" But after a little silence, Gwen just replied by saying, "Well, he's not my husband, but that sounded cool when you said that." But what really fixed this moment is the fact that after 5 years together, Gwen Stefani and Blake Shelton did go on to get married. What's even funnier is that she posted about the engagement on Instagram, and Dua Lipa actually commented on the news by referencing the cringy moment and wrote, "I guess our little interview aged well. Congratulations, best news." But whether or not Jimmy Fallon regretted having her on as a guest judge is something that still remains to be seen.
At number 5, Sharon Osbourne. Talk show host Sharon Osbourne found herself in some hot water earlier last year after she made some comments about Meghan Markle and Prince Harry that not only caused her to get backlash, but also lose a friend. Sharon Osbourne and Sheryl Underwood got into a heated argument surrounding Piers Morgan's comments about Meghan Markle. During the feud, Sharon backed up Pierce's comments about Meghan Markle's mental health, and this frustrated Sheryl because she didn't like the comments that were being made about those involved. The two got into a very heated debate that ended with a lot of drama, sparking a conversation about Sharon's ideals. She was called a racist, and a number of other accusations came out about how she's used various slurs in the past when talking about her other co-hosts. As a result of this, the network for their show launched an internal investigation, and that ended with Sharon being let go from the show.
Number 4, Kourtney Kardashian. For the Keeping Up with the Kardashian star, one of the biggest live TV fails came with her interview in 2016, just weeks after Kim Kardashian's horrific Paris robbery ordeal. Shortly afterwards, Kourtney appeared on Australian program The Today Show to talk about her latest project, before the hosts attempted to turn the conversation towards Kim. Quote, "We're very sympathetic and horrified, so we were wondering, how is everyone going? How is Kim doing?" Kourtney looked really frustrated and just said, before looking at somebody else in the room, most likely her publicist. An awkward silence ensued as her whole face went blank and she looked beyond the camera, muttering something under her breath about having someone come in. The presenters were confused as well, before they realized what was going on. David Campbell asked, "Hello, Kourtney, have we lost you?" before the silence became unbearable and Kardashian's face disappeared off screen. The host became frustrated at the response and insisted that Kourtney should have just said that her sister was fine. To this day, her response has fans divided over whether or not it was even appropriate.
At number 3, Howie Mandel. If you watched America's Got Talent, then you know that Howie Mandel and Piers Morgan were judges together. Through the time that they worked together, Howie was known to play pranks on Piers, like using fart machines on him and setting up vending machine blockades. Although Howie thought that this was all in good fun, Piers, on the other hand, wasn't impressed with his co-workers' antics and even going so far as to call Howie the quote, "most annoying man that he's ever met." End quote. Piers didn't like Howie so much that he ended up adding him to the list of celebrities who he had banned from his show. There was some bad blood there, but honestly, after learning about how many people Piers Morgan seemed to have beef with, this ban honestly doesn't even surprise me in the slightest.
Number 2, David Letterman. Even though Lindsay Lohan visited The Late Show in 2013 with the intention of promoting Scary Movie 5, David Letterman spent the majority of the interview talking about the star's forthcoming return to rehab. This one was really bad because as soon as she sat down, Letterman said, the actress looked remarkably well in a condescending tone. He then began asking invasive questions about whether or not Lohan steals things and manages her money responsibly. Despite all of her attempts to change the topic of conversation, the host kept going back to the question of rehab, like when was she gonna go, why was she going, and how long she planned to stay there. Eventually, the actress became frustrated and just said that they didn't discuss this in the pre-interview, while asking Letterman to focus on the positive. But even though she was clearly uncomfortable, he once again brought it up, and so by the end of the conversation, Lohan was literally in tears. The interview resurfaced online last year and has since sparked a wave of backlash against the veteran talk show host, who, in all fairness, has a pretty problematic history when it comes to making women uncomfortable on his show. Number 1, Cardi B. This one really takes the cake. On the after show of Love & Hip Hop New York, host Nina Parker asked cast member Asia Davies a question about her relationship with fellow co-star and ex-Swift, but before Asia could respond, respond, Cardi sent a heel flying in Asia's direction, a signature move that we all know way too well. Cardi then demanded that Asia admit that she had an issue with her. Quote, "You judge me because I was a stripper, say the truth." It was immediately clear why the two had been positioned so far away. After trash talking her for a little bit, the artist was ready to throw down again with Asia. In fact, Cardi needed a whole team to keep her from laying hands on her rival. But the rapper may have been right in the situation because Swift admitted that Asia did not respect Cardi because of her past. He allegedly had to explain to her several times that she was no longer a stripper, and she's moved on from that and is making music now. So when Asia refused to answer the question about why she didn't give Cardi a chance, her rival went into full attack mode. And what ensued is the televised disaster that you can still watch to this day.
At number 10, Hugh Grant. Hugh was once banned from The Daily Show after having a really bad interview that really affected the show's host because the actor was being so rude. Jon Stewart, the former host of The Daily Show, said in an interview that Hugh Grant was the absolute worst guest he'd had on the show. He spoke about how when Hugh was on to promote his film Did You Hear About the Morgans, Hugh was making a huge scene backstage and was just being really mean and annoying to the people who were working on set. Apparently, Hugh was allegedly going around saying that he had better places to be. He also got really upset about the clip that they played from the film, saying, quote, "What is that clip? It's a terrible clip," to which Jon replied, telling Hugh to make a better movie. You could really tell that Jon was fed up with Hugh and his attitude on the show. Jon went on to say that because of his poor experience with Hugh, he'd never have him back on his show. At number 9, Harmony Korine. I think it's an unspoken rule that when you're a guest somewhere, you should try to be on your best behavior. One person who really should have followed this rule is director Harmony Korine, who's best known for the movie Spring Breakers. It was once a time when Harmony made a number of appearances on The Late Show with David Letterman in the mid to late 90s. This was also during a time when Harmony was reportedly on a lot of drugs. Though he was a frequent guest on the show, his appearances just stopped all of a sudden and no one really knew why until 2013 when Letterman revealed the truth as to why the director was banned from coming on the show. Apparently, Letterman caught the director going through Meryl Streep's purse one time, and that was just the last straw for the late night host. When talking about this fateful event, Letterman said, quote, "I went upstairs to greet Meryl Streep and welcome her to the show. I knock on the door and she was not there. I looked around and saw Harmony going through her purse. True story. And so I said, that's it, put her things back in her bag and get out," end quote. After that, Harmony was no longer welcome on the show and hasn't been back since. Before we carry on talking about these rude celebrities, why not take a moment to leave a like on this video if you're enjoying it so far, and while you're at it, consider subscribing to the channel to see more videos like this one. At number 8, Bobcat Goldthwait. I think this goes without saying, but don't go setting fire to things. Back in 1994, actor Bobcat Goldthwait was a guest on The Tonight Show with Jay Leno, and during his guest appearance, the actor decided to just randomly set fire to his chair. At the time, Jay thought this was just a spontaneous bit, but in reality, Bobcat came prepared for this as he brought lighter fluid and a lighter that was hidden up his sleeve. Luckily, the other guest who was there that night, Lauren Hutton, was quick on her feet and doused the flames with a cup of water. Jay, understandably, was very unhappy with all this and banned Bobcat from the show. Not only that, but the actor was also charged with arson for this stunt and was ordered to pay over $3,300 in fines, some of which went towards replacing the chair he set fire to. He literally damaged the set, and if that's not rude, then I don't know what is.
Number 7, Harry Belafonte. This one is truly hilarious. The singer appeared on Eyewitness News to promote a documentary made about himself named Sing Your Song. But what viewers got out of the interview was a laugh, all because Harry was fast asleep when the anchor tried to speak with him. Eventually, the newscaster Layla Santiago ended up shouting at him, saying, "This is your wake-up call. He's meditating, he's taking a little nap," which caused all three newscasters on the show to erupt in laughter. His publicist later told the station that it was a technical glitch and that his earpiece wasn't working, so he decided to take the time to meditate before the interview. His publicist added that Mr. Belafonte is 84 years young, but sharper and more awake than most who have been interviewing him. Maybe the world would be a better place if more people took a moment to meditate. But in Belafonte's defense, it was probably pretty early in the morning during a time of filming. Whatever happened, the clip, which was from 10 years ago, only recently went viral after it was used to create a deepfake footage of President Biden dozing off while being live on air.
At number 6, Gene Simmons. I think we can all agree that Gene Simmons is kind of outlandish. He's a guy with a lot of energy and no filter, so when it comes to interviewing him live, you never know what he might say, but you can only hope that it won't be too offensive. At one point, the singer was a Fox favorite, making regular appearances on their programming where they would discuss hot topics in the world and would share their opinions on things. They liked the guy and liked having him on their show, but after causing a stir during a meeting at Fox and making some rude comments towards some of the other staff members, Gene got banned for life, and it was a hot topic of its own. Some of the things that Gene said to some of the women at the network got leaked, and it's not something you would want to have said to you, let's just put it that way. After all of that went down, the singer was not welcome back on their programming because they didn't like the way he behaved. At number 5, Jackie Mason. I'm sure we are all aware of how sensitive TV networks are about what kinds of things get aired. Saying some kind of adult word can cause some serious consequences, but what about hand gestures? Well, it turns out that those are also against the rules, and someone had their whole career ended because of it. Comedian Jackie Mason had been working on the Ed Sullivan Show for a bit back in the day, and it made him pretty successful. He was given a contract for 6 appearances, which was set to earn him around $45,000, which is more like $350,000 in today's money, since this all happened back in the mid-60s. Either way, it was a very well-paying job for only having to do 6 appearances. Anyway, his entire contract was essentially ripped up after he got into some trouble for flipping the bird on stage. Jackie was playing off one of the stage managers who was making gestures with his fingers to indicate how much time he had left, but he went a little too far. As part of his little joke, he pointed his finger around the room saying, quote, "Here's a finger for you, and a finger for you, and a finger for you," end quote. This kind of behavior was not allowed, and so he was booted off the show and subsequently banned. At number 4, Kelly Osbourne. Now, we just talked about Sharon Osbourne and her talk show scandal, but her daughter Kelly has also been in her share of controversies, including one that happened while on a talk show that kind of ruined her career because of a rude comment that she made. During an episode of The View, Kelly Osbourne really missed the mark when trying to clap back at Donald Trump, even though she was trying to diss Trump, and ended up getting in enough trouble herself. Just shortly before this episode aired, Donald Trump, who was at the time only a presidential nominee, was saying offensive things about the Latinx community and how he wanted to deport them. I'm sure we're all familiar with this one. Well, in a very poor attempt at clapping back at Trump's racist comments, Kelly said, quote, "If you kick every Latina out of this country, then who's going to be cleaning your toilet, Donald Trump?" What Kelly was trying to do was defend the Latinx community, but rather than stand up for them, she ended up offending them even more, as her remarks were interpreted as saying that the Latinx community is only good for being housekeepers, as depicted in many racial stereotypes. After facing so much backlash and realizing the gravity of her words, Kelly issued an apology saying, quote, "I want to start by saying I always take responsibility for my actions. In this particular case, I will take responsibility for my poor choice of words, but I will not apologize for being a racist, as I am not."
Number 3, Ellen DeGeneres. Celine Dion was not the least bit amused when she went on The Ellen Show in 2007 and got criticized for the fact that her son had long hair. Trying to be funny, Ellen outright told Celine that she was forgetting to cut her son's hair, then showed a photo of the cute little boy with shoulder-length hair. The issue is that Celine has probably gotten that same line from countless other people and was very tired of hearing about it. Ellen did not expect her to take the question to heart the way she did, and suddenly the tension in the room was so thick that you could cut it with a knife. Celine then began defending the length of her child's hair, asking Ellen if she had a problem with it. Quote, "Some people shave the head of their children and people say, oh, isn't that terrible? Well, I don't even cut my son's hair, and they say, oh my gosh, when is she going to cut her son's hair, you know? Whatever I do, I won't please anyone." She then explained that it was her son who made his own decision to keep his hair long, but Ellen had already sensed that she had made a mistake and swiftly changed the topic to Celine's music career after the uncomfortable moment.
At number 2, Mark Summers. When it comes to talk shows, sometimes you can never predict what's gonna happen. These shows are often used to catch up with a celebrity and just talk about life and whatnot, but sometimes these conversations can turn into brawls when the wrong thing is said, and this is pretty much what happened between Burt Reynolds and Mark Summers in 1994, when they were both guests on Jay Leno's talk show. The two men got into a heated brawl after some jokes were made that offended the both of them. Essentially, Mark Summers made a comment about how he was still married, while Burt, at the time, was going through a divorce, and it made Burt pretty upset. In retaliation, Burt threw some water at Mark, and that's what sparked the fight. It gets to the point where Jay Leno just can't keep the show together because his guests were fighting so much, and producers even went so far as to bring out pies for Mark and Burt to make it look like this fight was staged. After this, people got talking, and some people came to the conclusion that this brawl was uncalled for, and since Mark started it, he felt the most backlash. And finally at number 1, Ellen. In late 2019, actress Dakota Johnson sat down for an interview with Ellen, and some people see this interview as the one that started this whole Ellen is mean scandal because of how rude Ellen was. During the interview, Ellen berated Dakota about the fact that she wasn't invited to Dakota's birthday party. People saw this whole debate as incredibly unnecessary, but the part that people loved the most was how Dakota shut Ellen down. When Ellen said that she was mad for not being invited to Dakota's birthday party, Dakota in response said, quote, "Actually no, that's not the truth, Ellen, you were invited. No, last time when I was on the show last year, you gave me a bunch of crap about not inviting you, but I didn't even know you wanted to be invited," end quote. Dakota was even backed up by one of the show's producers who reassured Ellen that she was invited and that she just didn't show up because at the time, she claimed that Dakota's Malibu party was, quote, "a little too far for her." Dakota shutting Ellen down and not being made to look like the bad guy Ellen intended was great for fans, and following Ellen's cancellation, fans started to realize just how rude Ellen was. At number 10, Vivica A. Fox. You know, you don't always have to like everybody. It's okay not to be the biggest fan of someone, but for the sake of appearances, it might be a good idea to at least pretend like this person doesn't bother you. This could be extra good advice for celebrities as well. Because Hollywood is essentially one big show, having beefs with people isn't always the best thing for you, and watching two people who hate each other try to have a conversation can be painful as well. Take for example the bad blood between Vivica A. Fox and Jimmy Kimmel. To start, these two celebrities weren't the biggest fans of each other to begin with, but when the actress was on Jimmy Kimmel Live back in 2005, their bad blood started to really boil, and it led to the actress being banned from the show. The actress was on the show to promote her movie Missing, but things didn't go as smoothly as planned because as Jimmy made a joke about one of Vivica's friends, it made her upset and she ended up storming off the set, leaving Jimmy to finish the segment without his guest. Later on, he said that Vivica was one guest that he would never have back on the show. At number 9, Bill Hicks. Many times in Hollywood, we see people get in trouble for being too controversial. It's basically the backbone of cancel culture. Well, here's an example of someone being banned from a talk show for being so controversial that their segment was scrapped entirely. Comedian Bill Hicks made a number of appearances on Letterman between 1984 and 1993, but his 12th appearance on the show was scrapped after it was deemed too controversial to be aired. After that, a ban was issued. According to the comedian, Letterman, as well as the audience, didn't seem to have many issues with his set, but it was the show's executives who had the whole thing scrapped. This statement has been debated by some because a lot of people still took offense to some of the topics the comedian was discussing. Unfortunately, the comedian never got a chance to redeem himself on the show as he passed away a short time later. Now before I carry on telling you guys about celebrities who've been banned from late night shows, I would first like to take a moment to ask you guys to leave a like on this video if you're enjoying it so far, and maybe consider subscribing to the channel if you want to see more of our videos. At number 8, Madonna. It seems as though there's a good chunk of people who really don't like Madonna. There could be a million and a half reasons why she and others do not always get along, but the bottom line here is that not everyone wants to be friends with the singer, especially Piers Morgan. There seemed to be some kind of one-sided beef with the singer that frankly I don't think she cares about too much, but Piers on the other hand had a lot to say about her. Morgan said that Madonna was banned from his program because she is, quote, "boring and annoying." He also went on to say, quote, "Madonna and I, we've never really seen eye to eye. There was a bread roll throwing incident in London in the mid 90s. There was an incident at a hotel in the south of France at the Cannes Film Festival involving a photographer and a bodyguard. There's been an incident involving a pub owned by her recently departed husband Guy Ritchie, where my brother was the manager," end quote. If you thought he was done with his commentary on the singer, you thought wrong. Pierce also said that Madonna was too vegan for TV, whatever that means. Either way, Madonna never responded to all of Pierce's comments about her, so again, I think she remained pretty unfazed by the ban that he put in place, but clearly the TV host had some pent-up aggression there. At number 7, Piers Morgan. I feel like when a celebrity asks for something specific, it should be given to them. I'm not talking about anything material like demanding a cup of ice chips or something, I mean a specific request in reference to the way that they're treated. For actor Kelsey Grammer, he made a very specific request when he was doing an interview with Piers Morgan, and when that request wasn't honored, there was a falling out that led to the actor being banned from the show because of the drama. When the actor made a guest appearance on Piers Morgan Tonight back in 2012, he requested that a picture of his ex-wife not be shown. He's willing to answer questions about her, but just didn't want to have a photo of her to be aired. Well, Piers didn't exactly honor that request, and when a photo of the ex-wife was shown, Kelsey stormed off set. The actor's publicist said that Piers had to take accountability for his actions because Kelsey was so mad about the situation, but instead, Piers barred the actor from his show. That was pretty rude of him. At number 6, Kelsey Grammer. I feel like when a celebrity asks for something specific, it should be given to them. I'm not talking about anything material like demanding a cup of ice chips or something. I mean a specific request in reference to the way that they are treated. For actor Kelsey Grammer, he made a very specific request when doing an interview with Piers Morgan, and when that request wasn't honored, there was a falling out that led to the actor being banned from the show. When the actor made a guest appearance on Piers Morgan Tonight back in 2012, he requested that a picture of his ex-wife not be shown. He was willing to answer questions about her, but just didn't want to have a photo of her be aired. Well, Piers didn't honor that request, and when a photo of his ex-wife was shown, Kelsey stormed off set. The actor's publicist said that Piers had to take accountability for his actions because Kelsey was so mad about the situation, but instead, Piers barred the actor from his show. That doesn't really seem like the right thing to do in that kind of situation, but okay.
Number 5, Katy Perry. Katy Perry's 2017 interview with Ellen DeGeneres is a disaster from start to finish, and they're both partially to blame, although for different reasons. Things grew awkward really fast when Ellen forgot that Katy had once been married to Russell Brand. During a game of Will You Perry Me, a game where the singer was asked which celebrity crush she found more attractive, Katy said, "Do I have to get married again?" After a pause, Ellen looked genuinely confused and she just said, "You are not married." To which Katy said, "I was, when I was 25. Remember you gave me some wedding gifts on the show?" When the moment was becoming a little too embarrassing for the singer, she began making scissor motions, telling Ellen to cut this part of the interview out. But it only got worse from then on as Ellen launched into the game, which made a slightly unhinged Katy pick between Harry Styles, Chris Martin, and Leonardo DiCaprio. But she got a little too honest and said, "What if I've already kissed a bunch of these people?" The whole episode led to speculations that Katy was tipsy during filming, but we'll never really know the truth.
At number 4, Artie Lang. When you're a guest on someone's show, the expectation for celebrities is that they stay alert, engaging, and on their best behavior. For comedian Artie Lang, it seems as though he didn't follow through with that unwritten rule and he got banned because of it. Lang had been struggling with substance abuse, and though he had appeared on Conan O'Brien's show a number of times, he ended up getting banned because the producer thought that he was under the influence of some kind of substance on his last appearance, so they told him that he wouldn't be welcome back on the show until he was clean and could prove it. The studio didn't want to risk anything if Artie kept coming back while he was still using, and so they did it for his own good as well as to save their own image as well. At number 3, James Corden. Recently, TV host James Corden found himself in some trouble with fans after his Spill Your Guts segment of his show started facing backlash. Fans were calling for James to take accountability after he made some comments about some Asian foods that he had on the show that some fans thought were offensive. Because the foods that they use in the Spill Your Guts segment are supposed to be ones that you wouldn't eat, the fact that some Asian foods like balut were used and called, quote, disgusting, made a lot of people take to the internet to call for accountability and an apology from James Corden. Apparently, James had been making these types of comments about a lot of different Asian dishes on a few occasions, so some people have said enough is enough and even created a petition calling for the removal of the Spill Your Guts segment. At number 2, Gilbert Gottfried. This band has to be one of the most pointless bands I have ever heard of because it really wasn't necessary at all. Howard Stern banned Gilbert Gottfried from his show simply because the comedian went on another show. I know, I don't get it either. There wasn't even any bad blood between them. When Gottfried got canceled after making insensitive tweets about the devastating tsunami that hit Japan in 2011, Howard even came to his defense online, so really no one knows what the motive behind this ban really was. I'm sure it can't really be because he went on another show because that is so absurd, but honestly, we may never know. And finally, at number 1, Gene Simmons. I think that we can all agree that Gene Simmons is somewhat outlandish. He's a guy with a lot of big energy and no filter, so when it comes to interviewing him live, you never know what he might say, but you can certainly hope that it won't be too offensive. At one point, the singer was a Fox favorite, making regular appearances on their programming where they would discuss hot topics in the world and would share their opinions on things. They liked the guy and they liked having him on their talk show, but after causing a stir during a meeting at Fox and making some crude comments towards some of the other staff members, Gene got banned for life, and it was a hot topic of his own. Some of the things that Gene said to some of the women at the network got leaked, and it's not something that you would want to have said to you, let's just put it that way. After all that went down, the singer was not welcome back on their programming, and honestly, I can't say I blame them.